Morning, everyone. Welcome to our service. It's a good thing Sunday to thank God for the gift of all who have been mothers to us, to people, and as we see in the service, God's sort of being parent all the time to us as we belong to this church, this mothering community. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden,
cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and truly magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our Lord Jesus Christ said, the first commandment is this: Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is the only Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength. The second is this: Love your neighbour as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. These two commandments have all the law and the prophets.
Amen. The Lord have mercy.
Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, returned from the Jordan, was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, where for 40 days he was tempted by the devil. And so let us confess our sins, remembering before God the times we have fallen from temptation and into sin. We confess to you our selfishness and lack of love. Fill us with your Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord,
we confess to you our fear of failure in sharing our faith. Fill us with your Spirit. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
We confess to you our stubbornness and lack of trust. Fill us with your Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who in his great mercy has promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with heartfelt repentance and truth turn to him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
God of compassion, whose Son, Jesus Christ, the child of Mary, shared the light of hope in Nazareth, and on the cross drew the whole human family to himself. Strengthen us in our daily living, that in joy and in sorrow we may know the power of your presence to bind together and to heal, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Be seated to the first reading.
Chapter 2, reading from the first verse. Now a man from the house of Levi went and married a Levite woman. The woman conceived and bore a son, and when she saw that he was a fine baby, she hid it for 3 months. When she could hide him no longer, she got a papyrus basket for him, plastered it with bitumen and pitch, and she put the child in it and placed it amongst the reeds on the bank of the river. His sister stood at a distance to see what would happen to him. The daughter of Pharaoh came down to bathe at the river while her attendants walked beside the river. She saw the basket among the reeds and sent her maid to bring it. When she opened it, she saw the child. He was crying, and she took pity on him. "This must be one of the Hebrew's children," she said. Then his sister said to Pharaoh's daughter, "Shall I go and get you a nurse from the Hebrew women to nurse the child for you?" Pharaoh's daughter said to her, "Yes." So the girl went and called the child's mother. Pharaoh's daughter said to her, "Take this child and nurse him for me, and I will give you your wages." So the woman took her child and nursed it. And when the child grew up, she brought him to Pharaoh's daughter, and she took him as her own son. And she named him Moses, because, she said, I drew him out of the water. This is the word of the Lord.
Our gradual hymn is number 136, Fathers and Mothers. Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory. Blessed are those who have endured temptation, they have stood the test, and will receive the crown of life. Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
Meanwhile, standing near the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing beside her, he said to his mother, Woman, here is your son. Then he said to the disciple, Here is your mother. And from that hour the disciple took her into his own home. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
In times long past, before the Industrial Revolution, before towns and cities grew so huge and industrialized, Mothering Sunday was a time where young girls who were in service in large houses, which were a lot of people in those days, not only big grand houses, but most of all the smallest houses would have had a young girl working to help run the household. They were allowed to go back home to their own towns, to their own villages, to their own homes, to see their own mothers, but also to go on that Sunday morning to their home church, which was called their mother church. And that's where the Mothering Sunday really comes from originally, that people used to go go back home if they were able to their mother church, the church that kind of nurtured them, and back to their own mothers who they wouldn't have seen very often. Now we've seen from this morning's reading, from both of those readings, the Old Testament and the New Testament, that being in the role of a mother is about much more than just being a physical mother, because it's about whoever has that role in our own life. And for many people around the world today, the person who occupies that mother's role isn't necessarily a physical mother. It's probably most of occasions, but today on Mothering Sunday is a chance to give thanks to all those people who have had that kind of role in our own life. And it's also a chance to reflect on that idea of going back to a mother church like those people would have done hundreds of years ago. The sense that being a church is also about being a nurturing community. It's about having that sense of care and love for everyone in that community, just as a mother does for her child. So it's a kind of challenge to us, really, as a church, to say, how can we be better? How can we be better at that nurturing, and I'm delighted to say in this church, an inclusive community? How can we do that even better? So that we can be a nurturing for this church community, but also for the community that the church serves. How can we occupy that role of motherhood? So there's a couple of things I thought of in this. First of all, when we go right back to the start of the Christian story, where Jesus' mother, Mary, finds out that she's going to be a mother, or rather, she's given the opportunity to be a mother. A poem that I greatly love talks about and shows Mary being addressed by the angel, but only she can see the angel. Only she can see the angel because she has eyes of faith. And the poem talks about kind of angels being around all the time. But we can't see them because we don't have enough faith. You can imagine that. Imagine that God's messengers are here around us all the time. But it takes a belief, it takes a faith, it takes the eyes of faith to see them. And the poem shows Mary seeing the angel ever more clearly because she's kind of experiencing what that angel's presence is saying to her. And the more she experiences it, the angel, the more she's aware of the wings of the angel surrounding her and giving her protection, giving her nurture, giving her love. So the more she has faith, the more not only can she see the angel, but it's not just a matter of seeing the angel, she can see what the angel's doing, which is to surround her with care and with love, which is exactly what a mother does, isn't it? Exactly what the mother does, to surround the child with care, protection, and love. But also, if I could suggest that Mothering Sunday is also about seeing how God's relationship to us is like that of a mother, but it's also as a father as well. It's also as a father. Jesus calls God his father. But the word he uses isn't kind of a father, like a kind of Victorian child like him. But the word he used is Abba, Abba Father. And in the Aramaic language, Abba, that word, Abba meant, it was a word that kind of a young child, a young infant would use towards their dad. In other words, it's like daddy. It's it's a word that kind of implies a very close personal relationship. And Jesus uses that word, Abba, to show that his relationship with God is so close that it's like that of a small infant with their father. So this Mothering Sunday is also about realising how God's relationship with us is like that of a child, a little child, with a parent.
a little child utterly dependent on their parent, utterly trusting, utterly delighted when they see their dad, playful and happy when they're in the presence. That's what God's relationship to us, that's what God promises his relationship to us is. Well, as I know, as a parent myself, experiencing parenthood isn't like that 100% of the time, is it? I know it's like tidy rooms and like that. But there is that sense of closeness, there is that intimacy in any relationship of the parent and the child. And there's something else. As a parent, you're delighted when your child comes into your presence. There's a joy when you see your children. When my children ring me up from their jobs in London and the South, I still have a sense of joy. A sense of joy when you pick up the phone. A parent rejoices in the child. A parent is delighted when the child comes into their presence. A parent is delighted when the child wakes them up at 4 o'clock in the morning and says, "We've got to leave." And that's how God's relationship to us is. God loves us so much, like a parent would to a child. And he's delighted in us. And he's delighted when we come into God's presence. Because he loves us like a parent would to a child. God, if we come into God's presence and stand for God, God is delighted because he created us, he nurtures us, and he loves us. And he longs for us to be with him and receive the care and the joy that he wants to share with us. So on this Mothering Sunday, let's reflect on that. God's care for us is that of a parent who, with all the reality of who we are, loves us, nurtures us, and is delighted when we come into his presence. Amen. So let's stand now as we affirm our faith in the Word of God. We believe in one God, the Father of all the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified and on Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray.
We are children of a loving God who listens as a mother to our cries and know that we can bring our hopes and fears confident that they are heard. Loving God, our Father and our Mother, we thank you for those who love and encourage us and ask for grace to love and encourage others. We thank you for the family of the Church and pray that all may find in her their true home, that the lonely, the marginalised, the rejected may be welcomed. humbled and loved in the name of Jesus. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our
prayer. Loving God, as we see the brokenness of our world, we pray for healing among the nations, for food where there is hunger, for freedom where there is oppression, for joy where there is pain, that your love may bring peace to all your children. Praying especially at this time for the children of Palestine. We pray for all who thirst for justice, all who work to bring a better future for divided and warring communities, to bring education and a safe home for children in poverty, to bring medical help to the sick and the injured. Lord, in your mercy. Loving God, Jesus, your Son, was born into the family of Joseph and Mary. Bless all parents, grandparents, teachers, and all who care for children. Strengthen families living under stress, and may your love be known in places where no human love is found. You have given us the right to be called children of God. Help us to show your love in our homes, that they may be places of love, security, and truth. We pray for those who need the help of our food bank, and thank you for all those who provide the finance and the labour to keep it going. Lord, in your mercy. Loving God, we pray for all those who are weary, for the mentally ill, for the housebound. We pray for those whose lives are restricted by illness or self-isolation or anxiety. Show us, Lord, how we can help them. Make them a beacon, and make us a beacon of your love and hope. We pray for all from this community who are sick or distressed in any way, and for those who are anxious about them. In a moment of silence, we pray for all those whose needs lie in our hearts. May they know the comfort of your healing presence. Lord, in your mercy. Loving God, we give thanks for loved ones who have died, who are refreshed and restored in your kingdom. We pray that we may share with them in the fullness of life which is eternal. Lord, in your mercy. As those who want to follow Christ and walk the way of the cross, we offer these prayers in his name. Merciful Father,
I accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Please would you stand. Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
We offer one another the sign of peace. at all times and in all places to give you thanks and praise, Holy Father, Heavenly King, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Now we give you thanks because he was tempted in every way as we are, yet did not sin. By his grace, we are able to triumph over every evil, to live no longer for ourselves alone, but for him who died for us and rose again. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and singing. Sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world. He instituted and in his holy gospel commanded us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death until he comes again. Hear us, merciful Father, we humbly pray, and grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, we, receiving these gifts of your creation, this bread and this wine, according to your Son, Saviour Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. Who, in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance. Same way after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to you, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood, the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance. Christ is the bread of life.
When he eats his bread and drinks his cup, he proclaims your death, Lord Jesus, until you come into the world.
Therefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, in remembrance of the precious death and passion, the mighty resurrection and glorious ascension of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, we offer you through him this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Grant that by his merit and death, and through faith in his blood, we and all your church may receive forgiveness of our sins, and all of the benefits of his baptism. Although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer you any sacrifice, yet we pray that you will accept this, the duty and service that we owe. We do not wear merits, but pardon our offenses, and fill us with all the sharing that is coming to you. Your grace and heavenly blessing. Through Jesus Christ, your Lord, by whom and with whom we give you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Thank you.
So we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Lamb of God. Jesus, as a mother, you gather your people to you. You are gentle with us as a mother with her children. Often you weep over our sins and our pride. Tenderly you draw us from hatred to judgment. You comfort us in sorrow, bind up our wounds. In sickness you nurse us, and with your milk you feed us. Jesus, by your dying we are born to new life. By your anguish and labour we can come forth in joy. Amen. Now this looks very interesting. This is a junior church that says, why I love my mum. I have no idea what's written up here. So it would be like, this is like a plant, like nurturing, that is growing and being nurtured like as a mum does to the child. So I love my mum because she's good at hugs. She makes me dinner. Because she makes me happy. It's a good one, isn't it? I love my mum because she always loves me no matter what. Oh, that's what we've been thinking about in church, isn't it? Our God loves us just the same no matter what. She's always so kind and she always helps me. She's an amazing mum who has done such a lot for others and is always there for me. Mum's not just there for me, she loves us too. I love Mummy smile. It's a lovely thing to say, isn't it? She's always so nice and kind. And you are beautiful and delightful of God's love. And that comes from the Bible, from the book of Proverbs. There's all these things why we meet together to give thanks for mums today. And I think that there's something special now going to happen that we're going to ask children to come forward and to take one of these daffodils and to give them to all the ladies, all the women in church. So, children, would you like to come forward and take some of these daffodils? Take them round, we'll have some music, and they're going to be given to us as a token of God's love to all of the ladies, all the women in church. So we say our final prayer together. God of our pilgrimage, you have fed us with the bread of life. Renew and sustain us as we go forward on our journey In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please remember that all our services and talks by me are being recorded and put out on our new YouTube channel, St. Michael's Messages. Please do go on that channel, give it lots of likes, subscribe, encourage others to do so, and then we grow our presence on the internet and become more visible as a church in the community and all around the whole internet as well. Our final hymn this morning is number 656. He's got the whole world in his hand. Christ, give you grace to grow in holiness, to deny yourselves, take up your cross and follow him, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be with you and with all whom you hold in your hearts, and remain with you this day and always. Amen.